Sadia Rani here from the platform of Idea Training. You viewers are requested to subscribe our channel because it would strengthen us. Thank you very much. The topic today is how to develop interpersonal skills. And before we move forward, we must know what the interpersonal skills are. They actually are the fundamental skills in one's life. In one's life, interpersonal skills are the fundamental skills which must be developed first of all, before reading, before writing, before any other skill. We must develop our interpersonal skills. These are the skills, these are the set of skills actually which enable us to interact well with the people. Now let's start it with a little story. It's if you suppose you are in the court of a king and speak everything against his thought pattern. So you are wise enough to know what will become of you. Going against the thought pattern of the king is not a good thing. Just think for a while, what will be the consequences of it? Obviously, you will be out of that kingdom soon. You will be banned by that king, for sure. Well, I took the example of the kingdom and the king. Why? Because whoever do you interact with in your life, he is the king of himself. He or she is the king of himself. He is the king of his thought pattern. He is the king of his personality. Whatever he possesses, he is the king of that. And he does not want the people to go against them. In order to be friendly with him, in order to learn something from him or to get some advantages from that kingdom, you need to develop your interpersonal skills first of all. You must know that how to attract that person, how to take his attention, how to make him comfortable. Once you make him comfortable, first you have to tone him psychologically. Once you tone him, he is yours. He is yours because he is the king. The kingdom is yours. All the advantages will come your way. But if you are going otherwise, if you are doing otherwise, you will be out of the kingdom. Choice is absolutely yours. Now, interpersonal skills are that you as a person can sit amongst the diverse group of people peacefully. How to sit amongst the diverse group of people peacefully is to make them comfortable, to listen to them. If you take stock of your lives, whoever do you interact with, you will come to know. There is a very repeated word, I, my, ours. So, never try to go against that. Make the people comfortable in your presence. Transmit positive vibes around you. How to transmit positive vibes around you is to judge the thought pattern of the group of people you are sitting amongst and never dare to go against them. Then there is you in your presence, your success lies in that in your presence, people feel loved, cared for and respected. That's the first step of your success. Now, there are some factors behind interpersonal skills, and the first of all, it is active listening. Be a listener. If you try to judge the psychology of the people, you will come to know that when you are interacting with someone, he is least interested in the paradigm you are trying to convey to him. He is interested in explaining himself, his own thought patterns. He wants to tell you what he did in life. He wants to tell you what he likes. The first step is to be an active listener. Second of all is the flexibility. Though you don't agree with him, though you know more than him, that's not the question. Question is to make himself feel loved and respected in your presence. First you discover him, then a day will come that he will be quiet. His I, my, me, our, us will be quiet, and he will be asking you, what do you think about it? What is your view about it? So you should come up to that point. You have to be patient, come at that level, and then wait for the things which are supposed to be at that level. First reach that level. Then collaboration. Your strength does not lie in your intelligence. Do not turn your intelligence against yourself ever. Your intelligence is the gift of God. Use that in such a way that you have to be patient with the people. You have to collaborate with them. You have to ask them. First step is to ask them, what do they want? Then a point will come in your life that large group of people will recognize you as the wisest person among them, and then they will ask you to guide them in this way or that way, in making this decision or that decision. Empathy is also a factor behind it. Be kind anyway. Maybe the whole lot of people, what they are discussing, what they are talking about is all against your thought pattern. But be patient with them. Be empathetic towards them. Show kindness to them. Respect the difference they have. And once you respect all these things, you need a great deal of patience. And it will take you to the heights of glory. Motivation is another factor. Whichever the situation is, be motivating. Motivate the people. Look at their strengths and encourage them for that. That will make you a beautiful person indeed. Beauty does not lie in the brands you wear. Beauty does not lie in the makeup you wear. It lies in how caring you are, how empathetic you are, how respectful you are, how much comfort the people feel in your presence. That's your success. That's your beauty. That's what your God likes. Dependability is another factor behind your interpersonal skills. You should be trustworthy. People should easily depend upon you. Dependability, the first of all, your punctuality. If you are saying yes to a thing, you should do that. If you are saying yes to a time limit, you must be there by that time. That will count to your dependability. Positivity. Go for the things which you find in the people which are worth explaining, which will make them comfortable, which will make them proud of, and all that, humility is the biggest factor behind all these things. You should treat every person around you in such a way that if he were your boss, like you never think of making your boss angry. Every person in this world is the king, is the boss in himself, and also wants the treatment from you like you treat your bosses. Generosity. You must be generous. You must be generous in motivating the people, in encouraging the people, in spreading love, in accepting their differences and all that. The most important thing in communication is to hear what isn't being said. There are many challenges people are facing in their lives. Most of the time, you must be so empathetic that you must hear what is non-verbal as well. Only listening to and acting upon the verbal communications will not give you any kind of success. Maybe some kind of success you may achieve, but non-verbal communication also exists in the world, and God has made you very intelligent. The only thing is to polish your intelligence. You have to sharpen that. You must be observant. You must be positive. You must be kind-hearted. And this quotation fully explains my workshop, that the challenge that many people face when interacting with others is that they lack their necessary interpersonal skills which are needed for them to make their communication very effective. We lack interpersonal skills, and people start labeling us as an arrogant person. There is nothing like arrogance in the world. Arrogance does not exist in the world. That is actually something that we don't know what the interpersonal skills are. They are not developed. Once you develop them, there is no such thing as arrogance in the world. We are called arrogant when people detect something in us that interpersonal skills are not developed. Try to work on them, and one day you will be able to achieve this goal. A strong positive self-image is the best possible preparation for success. The first step is to give people your positive image. Make them comfortable. Make them easy with you. As easy the people are with you, that successful you will become. And I sum up my workshop saying that your intelligence is not enough for your success. Your strength, your success lies in sitting amongst the people. Embrace their imperfections. If you find them to be imperfect, that's what that makes them human. Humans are imperfect, you are imperfect, I am imperfect, we all are imperfect. Everything around you is a little more intelligent than you are. You don't know what he knows. You haven't been through what he has been through. And if you are put into that situation, maybe you and I behave like a failure in that situation, which he got through very easily. That was his task. This is our task. He is intelligent for that. You are intelligent for this. That's what the distribution of your God is. Smile of your friends depicts the success rate of yours. If you are going to perform something, don't go for the results. Don't wait for the results. Just have a look around the people. If you find an encouraging smile on their faces, your success is for sure. Thank you very much for listening to me.